Hello everyone, Sukom here. Welcome back to this channel, and if you're new to this channel, I post videos on 3D modeling and tutorials of solutions to engineering questions and problems. To get notified when I post a new video, I want you to subscribe to this channel and turn on the notification button so that you actually get alerted. In this video, I'll be teaching us how to navigate the interface of FreeCAD. And for those who don't know what FreeCAD is a free and open source general purpose parametric 3D CAD software which helps to model with infinite resources. And if you need help downloading FreeCAD, you can refer to my former video. I'm going to put the link in the description below. And one other special thing about FreeCAD is that the GUI of FreeCAD, the graphic user interface of FreeCAD, is similar to most CAD softwares out there. So you can easily transfer your CAD skills to other softwares like SolidWorks and other softwares out there. So I'll say that FreeCAD is an asset in itself. So now, going straight into today's tutorial, the first thing I would like to talk about is the file menu. So if you can see where the mouse pointer is at, the file menu. So then, just like other softwares, when you want to import a new document and start a new project, just click on new to create a new project, and then you have your workspace and everything you need. So basically, since we are talking about navigation of FreeCAD, you go to the edit menu panel, the toolbar, then you click on preferences. And so in the preference panel, this is where you get to change the settings that you want to your preference. So then the first one is language. So obviously I speak English, I'm going to use English. And here you get to select the accent color of your style sheet. So you can select dark green, and by the time I click on apply, you're going to see the change. You can see the change here. And if I click on light blue, you're going to see the change. So I'm just going to stick with dark blue. I'm going to stick with that. And it's advisable to set your toolbar icon to be in medium so that it is not small and at the same time it's not too big. It's just visible enough for proper use. And that's all you need basically on this page. You don't need to change any other settings on this page. And also, you go to the next one, which is the display. And so here you get to change the way you want it to be displayed to you. So here, I'm not going to be talking about this anti-aliasing. Anti-aliasing is what determines how smooth your model is. So by the time you create a model, the edges of your model, what determines how smooth it's going to be is depending on the anti-aliasing setting. And so I selected the maximum. So based on your system specification, select what's advisable to select the highest. So just click on it and click on apply, and you might need to restart the application for it to take effect. So that's what you need on this page, just to just get started. And then you can click the color of your page. As you can see from this background, I have a gradient color for the first color, the middle, and the last one. So for the first one, I selected this. So any color you choose is going to be there. So that's my preference. So I select OK. Then you're going to see the changes here. So once you click apply, as you can see, that is how it's going to change. So that's all you need to know about this part of the preferences. And also, you can also go through the preferences and choose other settings depending on your preferences. That's why it's called preferences. And so the next thing I'm talking about are the views in FreeCAD. So here you get the opportunity to see your model in the front view, the top view, the right side view, the back view, the bottom view, and the left side view. So I'll first create a model. So I'm going to go to the workbench, called the parts workbench, and I'm going to insert just a solid figure. So here you have it, this is just a cube, so you can properly understand it. So if I click on the front view, then this is the front view, then this is the top view. You might not really notice any changes, because a cube has even dimension, the length, the height, and the breadth, they're all even, so you might not really notice anything. But then when I change it to isometric view, by clicking on this toolbar here, then you can see that there's a change already. So just that's for your view. You want to change any to any view depending on what angle you want to see it from. So this is how you change it. And also your draw style, you can either select wireframe, select points, select hidden line, or select no shading. So I'll just stick with the first one as is, so to see it as it is. And also, peradventure you were modeling and you scaled your diagram too much and you want to downscale it, there's this icon here which is called the fit. It fits the model into the whole workspace. So you just click on it and fit it. And even if it's also too small, you can just click it and it brings it up to scale. so that you can properly visualize whatever it is that you're modeling in your FreeCAD. And so you see this panel right here. This is called the combo view. This is what allows you to see the amount of objects, the amount of solid figures you have in your worksheet. So I'm going to insert a cylinder by just clicking on this cylinder icon here, this toolbar. So as you can see, a cylinder has been inserted into my workspace. So, and by looking at the combo view, you can see the amount of objects I have, the cube and the cylinder. So to properly know the amount of objects and whatever it is on your work stream, you can just refer to your combo view. And also to change the dimensions, after clicking on cube, you come back to this place, you come down here, and then you see the dimension, the length, the width and the height. So you get to change the dimension. So for instance, if I change this to say 20, you can see the changes has been affected already. And if I change the width also to 20 and the height to 40, so I'm going to click on this to fit it to the worksheet. So you can see the changes. So to change the data, to change the dimensions of your particular solid figure or maybe a model that you made, so you can do it by referring to this panel down here. So I'll also do the same for the cylinder. You can also change the radius and the height. So I'll say, okay, let the radius be 5 and let the height also be 40. And so you can see it. That's basically what the combo view is all about. It helps you to properly identify the object and the models you have on your worksheet, and to also change the specific dimensions. Since FreeCAD is a parametric software, that is, it deals with variables and data to make your model. So then you can change those models by referring to the combo view. So another very important thing I'm going to be talking about is the workbenches in FreeCAD. So basically everything you're going to be doing on FreeCAD, you're going to be dealing with workbenches, and there are two major workbenches that you're going to use in almost all your projects on FreeCAD, which is the parts design, which I'm currently on, and the parts design. So wait for it to load. So this is the parts design workbench. So depending on the kind of project you are about to perform, if I just want to create just a regular model of something, so I could just use this and manipulate the object to form a particular model. And if the model I'm trying to create is not, the tools are not on this page, so then each workbench holds a particular set of tools I can use. So now if I'm on parts design workbench, I get the chance to create a sketch and then either perform an extrusion operation on the sketch or a pocketing operation on the sketch. I'm going to go further into that later on in this tutorial. You have to create a body before you can work on the parts design workbench. So you click on create a body. So after creating a body, then you create a sketch. Since you cannot do anything without a sketch, so you're going to choose your axis plane. Then you click on OK. So then depending on the sketch that you make, that just determines how your model is going to appear. So depending on the operation you want to perform, that will determine the workbench you use. So you have different workbench. You have the architecture workbench. So here you have it. These are the tools that you need. So you have other workbench, you have the draft, you have the drawing, you have the inspection, we have the mesh design, we have the OpenSCAD, that's for programmers who intend to use code to make their models. You have the part design, you have the parts workbench, you have ray tracing, you have robots, you have Sketcher, you have different workbench. You also have the assembly workbench and the animation workbench. So depending on the sketch you are trying to make, depending on the project you have at hand, that will determine the workbench that you focus on. So that's just on workbenches. So that was pretty much all you need to know about navigating in FreeCAD. So as a beginner in FreeCAD, those are the basic things you need to know to get started on FreeCAD. If this video was helpful to you and impactful to you, click on the like button and don't forget to subscribe so that you can get notified when I drop other videos. And till next time, keep practicing and stay sharp.